everyone. This is for subject mathematics, class 7th, lecture number 1. And in this lecture, we will cover chapter 2, fractions and decimals. In this video, we will cover these concepts that are introduction to fractions, type of fractions, and equivalent fractions. So we will cover these topics in our first lecture. So let us start with the fractions. What are fractions? A fraction represents a part of a whole. What it says? It is a part of a whole. Whole means a complete number, and it is a part of that complete whole. Or you can say any number of equal parts. That is a fraction. I have given you an example. This is one circle. This is one. This is the shaded part is 1 by 2 of the circle, complete circle. It means this is the part of the whole. Whole is a circle we have. So this is two part. This is shaded two part and two are remaining. So the shaded part is 2 by 4. So this is 1 by 2. Next one is, this is three shaded part and whole is a four part. So this is 3 by 4. Same here, this is 1 by 4. So this is the fraction. Or simply I can say a fraction represents parts of a whole. Or you can say when something is broken up into a number of parts, the fraction shows how many of those parts you have. Suppose I have broken these and I have three shaded parts. So I am writing as 3 by 4. Now let us discuss about types of fractions. We have, first one is proper fraction. Before this, let us discuss about numerator and denominator. So this is a fraction. Suppose 3 by 4 is a fraction. When writing a fraction, there are two main parts, the numerator and the denominator. The numerator is how many parts you have. The denominator is how many parts the whole was divided into. So let us take this. This is one is numerator. This is two is denominator. Here one is three is numerator and four is denominator. Again, I am repeating. The numerator is how many parts you have, and the denominator is how many parts the whole was divided into. The whole was divided into four parts in this one, and you have three parts. So this is 3 by 4. Now come to the types of fraction. Proper fraction. A proper fraction is one where the numerator is less than the denominator. Where the numerator is less than the denominator. Please note that a proper fraction is always less than 1. You can take an example. Here the numerator is less than denominator. Here also the numerator is less than denominator. So we have, these are proper fractions. You can search more examples. You can think more examples of proper fraction. Now come to the improper fractions. An improper fraction is one where the numerator or denominator is greater than, numerator is greater than the denominator, or numerator is equals to the denominator. Improper, note that improper fraction is always greater than 1. We have some examples of improper fractions. They are 4 by 3, 7 by 7, 12 by 5. Here we can observe that numerator is greater than the denominator. So these are improper fractions. Now come to the next one, that is mixed fractions. Mixed fraction, a mixed fraction had both a whole number part and a fractional part. They have both the whole number and a fractional part. Or you can say when whole number and a proper fraction combined, then they became mixed fractions. Suppose I am taking one example, 3 whole 1 by 4. This is 3 whole 1 by 4. How you will read it? 3 whole 1 by 4. Or you can say 4 whole 1 by 2, 7 whole 13 by 15. These all are mixed fraction because they are combined with the whole and the fractional part. So these are mixed fractions. So we have covered the types of fraction. Now one more topic we have to study, that is equivalent fractions. What are equivalent fractions? Sometimes fractions may look different, but sometimes fraction may look different and have different number, but they are equivalent or have the same value. Suppose 2 by 3 is a fraction. They are different numbers, but they are equivalent because they have the same value. When you are making them in simplest form, they became the same given number. So these are the equivalent number. Or you can say fractions may look different and have different numbers, but they are equivalent or have the same value. As it is written, these are different fractions. Fractions the name, this but the same number, they are the same number. So this is equivalent fraction. 2 by 3 is equivalent to 4 by 6, 6 by 9, 8 by 12. How you will find it? By multiplying numerator and denominator by first by 2, you will get this. 2 by 3, by multiplying it and numerator and denominator with the same number, you will get the second equivalent. By multiplying it with, suppose I am taking 4, I am multiplying numerator and denominator by 4, I will get 8 by 12. So these are my equivalent fractions. Now, what we have covered, let us recall the concept we have learned. We have learned about the fractions. A fraction is a part of whole. After this, we have learned about the types of fractions. After this, we have learned about equivalent fractions. Now, let us discuss some questions on exercise 2.1. Question number 1, I am taking two parts, that is part number 6. First I am taking, this is you have to solve 2 whole 2 by 3 plus 3 whole 1 by 2. They are mixed fractions and you have to add them. We will learn how to add and subtract the fractions. First I will convert them in improper fractions. That is 3 to just 6, 6 plus 2 8 by 3 plus 3 to just 6 plus 1 7 by 2. Next step, you have to take the LCM of the denominator. So LCM of the denominator is 6. Now you have to, this is the LCM. What you have to do with this LCM, you have to divide it with denominator. 6 divided by 3, what you will get? You will get 2, and 2 is multiplied with the numerator, what you will get? 16. Same here, the denominator is first divided with the, sorry, the LCM is first divided with the denominator, and what comes? You have to multiply it with the numerator. So it will be 8 into 2 plus 7 into 3, that is 16 plus 21. So this is your 16 plus 21 is 37 by 6. If you want to convert them in mixed fraction, then divide it. This is your quotient, this is your remainder, and this is your divisor. So this is the answer of sixth part. Let us discuss seventh part. Here you have been asked about the difference, how to find the difference in the fractions. Again, this is a mixed fraction, this is also a mixed fraction. I will convert them in improper fraction first. 2 8 is 16 plus 1 17 by 2. 8 3 is 24 plus 5 29 by 8. Again the same process you have to follow in addition as well as in subtraction. LCM of two denominator is 8. Then same procedure you have to follow. This is the LCM. Divide it with the denominator of every fraction. What comes? Multiply with the numerator. Here 8 is divided by 2, you will get 4. 4 is multiplied with 17, you will get this. Here it is minus, so write minus. Again 8 is divided by 8, you will get 1, and 1 is multiplied by 29, you will get this. So this is my 17 into 4 68 minus 29, you will get this. So this is the answer. If you want to convert in mixed, it's up to you. divide this fraction and you will get the mixed fraction. Now question number 2 of exercise 2.1. Some fractions are given, you have to arrange in descending order. These types of question you might learn in class 6 also. So 2 by 9, 2 by 3 you have to make them in descending order, arrange them in ascending. Same procedure you have to follow. First you have to take the LCM of denominator. Here the LCM of denominator I have taken is 63. I have taken the LCM. So this is 63. Now for each fraction you have to make their denominator equals to the LCM. So our first fraction is 2 by 9. So 2 by 9 you have to make this denominator 63. So you have to think a number so that you multiply it with numerator and denominator so that the denominator gets 63. So I just thought a number 7. If I multiply them numerator and denominator, I will get the denominator as 63. This is our first fraction. Now come to the second fraction. This is 2 by 3. If you multiply them, you have to think a number so that multiplying the denominator you will get 63. So that number is 21, that you get 42 by 63. Now next is 8 by 21. You have to think a number so that your denominator should be 63. So just I have taken 3, I have multiplied it by numerator and denominator by 3, you will get 24 by 63. The numerator, now these fractions all have the value denominator 63. Now the numerator, now I have arranged these as in their decreasing order. This is the smaller one, this is the smallest one, then this, then this. This is the largest one. Just I have considered the numerator. After the making the denominator same, the bigger the numerator, the bigger the number is. So this is the largest one. This is smaller than this one, and this is also the larger, smaller than this one. Sorry, this is the smallest one, this is smaller than this, and this is the largest one. Same, this is our question. Now, I request everyone to note down the homework. You have to do question number 1, part 1 to 4th, 1 to 4. We have discussed question 6th and 7th part here. Question number 2, B part, and examples of exercise 2.1 in your homework notebook. So this is all about lecture number 1 of chapter 2. Now let us discuss the homework solution of lecture number 4. In this, I will cover these questions I have given you as your homework. Question number 1, D, G part. Question number 2, B part. Question number 3, all the remaining part. And question number 6. I have given this as your homework in lecture number 4. And I will discuss only the difficult questions in which you students might face some problems. So let us start the discussion by taking question number 6 first. In a class test, plus 3 marks are given for every correct answer and minus 2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. It is given that there is a test in which plus 3 marks are given for correct answer and minus 2 are given for incorrect and no marks for non-attempting any question. We have the first part now. Radhika scored 20 marks. She get 20 marks. If she got 12 correct answer, how many questions has she attempted incorrectly? Simply the question is asking, if a girl get 20 marks in which she got 12 correct answer, the question is asking about how many questions she attempted incorrectly. So let us discuss the solution. Marks obtained for one right answer, this is given plus 3. Marks obtained for one wrong answer, this is also given minus 2. Now total marks she get is 20. I will find the marks first she obtained in correct answers. So marks obtained in 12 correct answer will be 12 into 3, that is 36, because 3 she get in one correct answers, right answer. So she attempted 12 correct answers, so she will get 36 marks. Now marks obtained for incorrect answer, that will be total minus marks in correct answers, that is 20 minus 36, that is minus 16. Always remember, marks she will obtain incorrect will be negative, because in incorrect marks answers she is losing her marks, or the marks are deducting, and deducting shows minus. So marks obtained for one wrong answer is minus 2, it is given in the question. Total number of incorrect will be marks in incorrect over marks in one incorrect answer, that is 8. Therefore, she attempted 8 questions wrongly. What this question is simply saying, there is a girl, she get 20 marks, and the question is saying she got 12 correct answers. So how many questions has she attempted incorrectly? We have given the total marks 20, and first we will find the marks in incorrect answer, that is 36. So first I will find the marks in incorrect answer, that is total minus marks in correct, that is minus 16. Then I will find number of incorrect answer, because minus 16 she is deducting, she is getting in incorrect, and minus 2 for one wrong answer. So 8 will be the number of wrong questions she attempted. Now same for second part. Second case, it is given Mohini scores minus 5 marks in his test and she get 7 correct answer. This is the same type, only the number of correct answers has been changed. Now the question is asking how many questions has she attempted incorrectly. Same way we will solve. Marks Mohini get is minus 5. First we will find marks she obtained in 7 correct answer, that is 7 into marks in 1 correct answer, that is 21. Then I will find marks in incorrect answer, that is total minus marks in correct answer, that is totally here given is minus 5, and this is she get in correct answer. So this is minus 26 in incorrect answers. Now it is given marks obtained for one wrong answer is minus 2, and therefore number of incorrect answer is total marks she get in incorrect answer divided by marks of one incorrect answer, then you will get 13 is the 13 is the number of questions she attempted wrongly. So simply now the Mohini score minus 5 in the test and she get 7 correct answers. Now the question, how many questions has she attempted incorrectly? Same, I will find marks for 7 correct answer, that is 21. Then I will find marks in incorrect answer, that how you will get total marks minus marks in correct answers. So minus 5 is the total, so minus 21, this will gives you minus 26. So minus 26 is divided by marks in one incorrect answer, that is 13. Therefore she attempted 13 questions wrongly. So this is the lecture solution part of lecture number 4. Thank you.